Okay, so Ampere's Law Part 2. I was really rushing that to try and get that in, but let me just repeat that. It's so fast to repeat. So let's say I have a current this time, the wire's coming, the current's actually coming out. So that means that the field is going to go this way. So if I want to know the B right here, that's what I'm after, the actual strength of the B right there. Then I'm going to draw an Amperian loop. I'll be a little more careful with this Ampere loop. It's got a radius R. And I just apply Ampere's law. Mu naught I is equal to mu naught I is equal to the integral of B dot dl. Now I'm going to say that the total I coming out of there is just capital I. So this will just turn into mu naught times I. That's how much current is going through the Amperian membrane. And that's equal to, now I'm going to make the argument since the field is this way, B is upward this time. Right here, B is this way. Right here, B is this way. Right here, B is that way. And so since B and DL, we'll always pick DL to be in the same direction as the B. See how they're parallel at every point along the way? DL is this little vector, and I don't mean to have a curve. It's actually a straight vector, but because it's so little, they make up that loop. And so I'm going to get rid of the dot product because B is parallel to DL. At all points on the, at all points on the Ampere loop, AL is Ampere loop, and then since I'm going to make the argument that since you're at the same location at each one of these points, it's the same distance R away from the wire, then I'm going to make the argument that B shouldn't be any different at each point on here as far as magnitude goes. Not direction, but magnitude. And so that's why we need symmetry. Without symmetry, we can't make that argument. But because it's symmetric, I can. And so mu naught times I is equal to, I'm going to pull that B out. And now I'm summing up all the DLs. This is saying sum up all the DLs. Oops, we got rid of the vector. And when we're summing up all the DLs, this is actually a definite integral. It's saying start at some point and don't stop summing them until you get all the way around and the entire loop. This is no longer an area. This is actually a loop that you're going around. And so when you do that, then you're going, well, let me give you this argument. This argument, why I was able to do that, is that B is uniform at all points on the Ampere loop. And then when I add up all those DLs, then I get that it's B times 2 pi r. Okay, let's bring the 2 pi r on the other side. And so if I were to graph this, what is B, how does B vary with R? If I were to graph this, it looks like it does one of these. It's like a 1 over x graph. Okay. So that's the basics behind Ampere's law. Now, just like Gauss's law had all sorts of applications to that, so does Ampere's law. And so I'll just show you now a few applications of Ampere's law in the next video. All right, thanks. Bye.